Of course, things were different back then. We were so happy. We didn't really think about it. But we were just so happy. And so oblivious to what was about to happen. Uncle Bill was staying with us the day it happened. He'd just come back from Cardington, of course. I was upstairs with Mum, helping upholster a dress for a dance at the hall. She always let me help, even if she had to redo my bits later on. We had the radio on, and of course we were listening to O'Connor's Sunday Lunch. We always had it on in the sewing room. Dad and my older sister Jill were downstairs with Uncle Bob watching telly. The radio stopped all of a sudden. And then we heard a noise. It's hard to explain the noise now as it's such a distant memory. I do remember it sounding like some sort of piano from the future, which descended down in tone. It played a few times and was over as quick as it began. Everything went quiet after that. I heard my dad downstairs ask Bill if it was okay. He kept saying his name. Then we heard what sounded like the start of a scream from a few doors down. We looked out of the window to try and spot the commotion. It ended so abruptly we couldn't place it. Then it happened at ours. It sounded like someone was banging on the table downstairs over and over again. Mum went down to see what it was. I heard her on the stairs. She covered her mouth and I could hear her purposefully stop her breath. She slowly tiptoed back up the stairs and into the spare room with me. She shut the door as quietly as she could and opened the wardrobe door. I didn't know what happened, but all of a sudden we weren't happy anymore.
Thank you. Abusing.